Okay, so I'm just gonna pick a card. Pile one, Pyrite, aka Fool's Gold. Love it. I think it's my favorite. Gorgeous. Number two, Russian Doll. Lovely gift from my sister. She gets me one every year. So sweet. That's number two. Number three will be the rose. So this is a love message. So I got my little three loving things. That's number three. I picked my most romantic loving decks. So I have the Romance Angels by Doreen Virtue. This is definitely love energy. And then we have Joie de Vivre Tarot by Paulina Cassidy. This is, I find this a very romantic looking deck. So, let's go there. And then I have Love Your Inner Goddess. Love Your Inner Goddess. And if you're male, this applies to you as well. Oracle cards to express your divine feminine spirit, so your feminine side, if you're masculine. Alana Fairchild. There we go. So we'll do all decks. First, let's move these to the side. Unexpected money. Ooh, maybe that's a message for all of us. We might be getting some of that. Gotta put that back where it belongs. Okay, so got the angel, romance angel cards. That box lit. And then this beautiful. Joy in living. Inspiration. That's pretty. These ones are nice. Kind of gold. And then this one. Love Your Inner Goddess. Did I already say this? Yes, I did. These ones are solid red. Really nice colors and artwork. This deck. This is the romantic one. Just the soothing, soft colors. I'm making a video. I guess my sister wanted something. But later. And then this romantic back here. Who's got gold? Edges. Really nice. Okay. Let's get the messages. First, we'll do the tarot deck. the Death card. And Reconciliation. Someone from your past is returning to your life. Okay, interesting. Pile number one, Pyrite. This is very interesting. So your overall energy is the Six of Cups, and this is a very sweet energy. It's a very loving energy, again, heart space. So this means that something from your childhood, something that's been not necessarily your childhood, but many, many, many years, just that innocent space you're in when you're younger, you know, it's different. You view love differently. That's the overall energy. So this is a really good thing, because that type of love is coming to you, is already there, or is on its way in the near future. So this one is very simple. So this one is a death of something. A relationship. This is a love reading, so this is what it is, pile number one. Something has passed, and you can see it was something beautiful and dear. So even though it's hurtful, and something has died, you know, or just been put to rest, it was a very beautiful thing for you. You really learned and you grew, and you're full of hope. You're hopeful for what's to come in love. And you're open. You're very, very open, which is great, because the next card is someone from your past is returning to your life, which is interesting, because you can see the sort of sad energies are in the past. She's moving forward to the light. This is describing you. Okay. Your heart may have been broken in the past. It most likely was, because this is the Death card. But you're like still, you know, delicate, and you're moving forward, and you're really hopeful for this love that you're gonna get. And again, this is that overall energy, that child space of kind of love, and you see it innocently, and it's like special and different. So this is gonna be someone from your past that's gonna come. And then we also have the overall energy for the Romance Angels as children. Your love life is being affected by children. And that doesn't mean if your love life is affected by children, then your love life will be non-existent, or you won't get that space in the future. Just because children are involved. This message, because it's very sweet. This energy, pile one, Pyrite. You chose Pyrite. You're very sweet and open to finding love, which you will get, someone most likely from your past. It's not going to be rushed. It's not going to be something rushed. It's going to be very sweet and loving from this innocent space. And children will be involved in some way or another. You might be a new person in these children's lives, or you might be an existing person in these children's lives. But it's just saying that it's kind of like a bonus. Affected doesn't mean negatively affected. This, in this reading for this pile, is a bonus. There's going to be children in the mix somewhere. So this is a great little simple message from Pyrite, pile one. Hope you liked it. Very simple. I gotta keep these overall energies. There's this one and this one. Seems fine. Oh, we forgot a message. I am a goddess. Can I just please bless this deck one by one? What message do you have for You are the light. Oh, when darkness surrounds you, be the light. That makes sense. It goes. That death guard that you had, that hopeful little soul, that's kind of been tattered and bruised and blue. When darkness surrounds you, be the light. You can see she's a little bit sad too, but super still passionate and loving life and it being content in her life, which is your life, just to be content, okay? When darkness surrounds you or has surrounded you, be content. Know that you're special. Okay, so that's your message. And then we'll do pile two. The Russian doll. She's like, oh, I think I want some love. That's her little expression. According to me. So this is pile two. And angels, what message do you have for pile two? This one. Cool. Okay. So let's look at the cards here first. Just need a minute. Okay. I think this reading is for someone who's not in a partnership. And or someone who is in a partnership that is evolving, sort of maybe like the beginning maybe or stages. So single or just starting something in your love life, okay? Pile two, Russian doll. So after having said that, let me read your divine goddess message. Your inner goddess, okay? It says, I am a million different things at a million different times. I am me, with no apologies. Okay, wow, that's great. This is encouraging after reading the cards. So, before reading, I'll say, you just be you, keep doing you. And don't apologize for who you are. So the tarot card is the Ten of Wands. So this space that you're in right now is you carrying a lot. You have a lot in your back pile too. You have a lot of things going on, but you can see in this a lot of things going on, maybe even just a lot of different love opportunities. And that, so remember this message is for people who are pile two, single or just starting something. So you have a lot of passion, you have a lot of love to give, and a lot of earthly things too, but you're carrying too much, and you're kind of falling, so maybe you're not focusing in enough on one person, pile two. Okay. Financial issues are a factor in your love life right now, so maybe some of these earthly things that you're carrying, or, you know, job, or like working too much, or putting too much energy into that instead of your loving relationships and possible loving relationships. So financial issues are a factor in your love life right now, so maybe you're thinking too much about money for the love to come, because remember, this is for singles or just starting something but not fully invested. Maybe you're too distracted by your job, your duties, your responsibilities, your financial responsibilities, your household responsibilities, your social responsibilities. You feel a little weighed down by possibly all those things or some of those things. But your prayers and affirmations and visualizations help you to bring you together, help you together. And the next clue to it is work on your partnership. So this is if you have something just starting, work on that. And if you're single, then continue or maybe delve more into working on that partnership with someone. Maybe you're, again, just too involved in your work or social life to be focused on the love, the loving part. Focus, whether you're taken or single, focus on prayers, affirmations, and visualizations that help bring you together. So even just have a little daydreams, get yourself into that space. Think or dream about things that you do want for yourself. And then it says someone is wearing a false self-mask in this relationship. So you, or possibly another person, or the other person. But I think it applies to you, because I think you're a little too focused on what's going on around you rather than what's going on within you. Because this romantic relationship that you crave is something, or that you want fuller of, more of, something really deep within you. So I think you need to be focusing on other things, like your heart space, instead of like stuff that's going on around you, like I described before. But remember, the overall message, you're a million different things. You're all these things. You know, it's just kind of weighing on you. So you need to set those things down and focus on calling in your soulmate. The angels are helping you, guiding you do that. You can have that. Okay. So that's what I would stay focused on. This little energy, this little busy bee. Get into that loving space, light some candles, you know, lay down in a dark space, get comfy, and focus on the things you want to come into further fruition, or something totally new that you want. Little busy bee, settle down, settle down. That's what I'm doing. So we have Eight of Wands. Mm-hmm. Queen of Wands. Ooh. Let's see this. Okay, this is what I was hoping for. A clear message like this. New love. A new person has stirred your romantic feelings. So this is pile three. This is so cute. So this speaks to a single person. This is just a single person. And if you're not single and you picked this pile, maybe this still applies to you. Maybe this is still something that your energy that you're in right now. Because we all know that not all relationships are straightforward and easy to navigate. So anyway, regardless, this is very simple. Eight of Wands, so this is your energy right now. Eight of Wands, so you just are, again, passionate, explorative little person. And in regards to love, pile three, you are like, yay, let's go, let's do this. But you're like super calm while you're doing it. You're excited, you're happy to be where you are, which is great. See, he's on this little spaceship. He's got little aliens around him, little different little beings, creatures. And his little wand that's shining the way. And he's like ready to explore, ready to dive in. Which is great because your romance angel says, new love coming in. A new person has stirred your romantic feelings. Which makes sense because the card next to this one is this one, which is the Queen of Wands. And you can see, and as you know, queens, they have all that love to give and ready, and they're settled and mature. So this is you. So you're ready to explore, and now you're ready to grow something. You can see she's feeding her little sunflower in the face. So you're ready to move forward and accept something that's really gonna come in, a new love, a new person. So if this person hasn't come in life yet, just know that it will in the very near future. And these are both wands, so that even could be spring, which is a while from now, but you know, it's really not. Time flies by, and that's just a possibility. It could come sooner, sometimes a little bit later, depending on what energy you choose to stay in. It depends. But this one, pile three, you pick pile three, you're just well on your way to finding and blooming a new love. So yay, that's exciting. And again, I forgot for pile two, but the underlying overall energies was, again, children. So your new love might have children, or you might have children. But it's a good thing, it's a positive thing, it's gonna only make it better. And then the Six of Cups, that innocent, pure love, which matches nicely with both of these energies. So stay in that space, stay in that sweet, loving, curious space, because that's going to bring you good things. And then your Divine Goddess, a little bit of advice on what to do to stay in that space. Moonchild. Focus on your dream space. That's what I'm getting from this card. Moonchild. And also that 70s vibe. Even if you listen to 70s music. Yes. Listen to 70s music. You sweet little thing. Pile three. Pick the rose. Super sweet, okay? Your sweetheart. Get into that 70s feeling. Relax too and like have a good time. Just enjoy the moment. Pile three. And a new love in many different ways will be coming for you. Yes, I said coming for you. That's it. It's gonna be fun. So that's my readings. I hope pile three made you feel good and excited about the future. And all the piles, they were great. Thanks for watching. Bye.